Good morning. Today we are taking up explanation of the poem Lapis Lazuli by W.B. Yeats. Harry Clifton gave Yeats a Chinese carving in lapis lazuli on his 70th birthday. The poet finds himself meditating about the role of arts in our lives. The poem opens with some hysterical women complaining that the musicians, artists, painters are thoughtless and shallow. The world war is in offing, and instead of making efforts to stop it, they are painting, singing, and playing their instruments. Some major steps have to be taken to avoid the imminent disaster. Otherwise, aeroplanes and zeppelin will bombard the city and raise it to the grounds. The women are scared and paranoid. Painters with palette and singers with their compositions, musicians with their instrument fail to impart relief from anxiety. The town will be destroyed by bombs and something drastic will have to take place. Otherwise, women feel when they remember King Billy, William of Orange, in the Battle of Boyne, and that makes them more anxious that something similar is going to happen to their place. In this stanza, the poet defends fine arts and says that it helps in restoring balance, uplifting our spirits and filling us with tranquility. He explains it with examples from tragedies that are performed on stage by actors. He says that they play the role of Hamlet, Lear, Ophelia, and Cordelia. And when they enact their roles, they know that it has pessimistic ending. They neither are disheartened nor they break down weeping on the stage, as they understand that all the characters are happy and gay. The enactment of tragedies make it a beautiful experience for the characters in understanding of the life. It helps them to transcend their tragic surroundings. The poet argues that the war hysteria, as well as overwhelming emotions and anxiety, can be controlled by fruitful use of arts. Acceptance of fate illumines the self and broadens the understanding of life, and that the piling of horror upon horror cannot further add to the tragedy. The enactment of tragedy on 1,000 stages simultaneously taking place cannot increase the tragedy more than it really is. The poet then argues by giving examples from history. He says civilizations have come and gone. One should not be disturbed if our civilization is also destroyed. Conquerors, along with their armies, have arrived on foot, on ship, camelback, horseback, or on mulebacks, and destroyed the old civilizations and their wisdom. Callimachus, the Athenian sculptor, made beautiful things of marble. He sculpted marble statues, and his artistry was so marvelous that the garments appeared to move with the gust of wind. But nothing remains now. Everything is destroyed. All things fall and are built again, and those who rebuild it rejoice in making great art. The poet gives a detailed account of the carved semi-precious blue stone, that is lapis lazuli, in this stanza. The poet imagines it that there are three Chinamen. One is ascetic, another is a disciple, and the third one who is following them is a servant carrying a musical instrument. A long-legged bird, that is a symbol of longevity, is flying above them, indicating these men will have a long life. Although human life is short, but the knowledge and experiences vast. Every discoloration of the gemstone, crack or dent is imagined by the poet as a water stream or an avalanche or a lofty slope. There are beautiful plum or cherry trees on the way, and there is a halfway house towards it. These Chinamen are moving up. Poet feels elated visualizing these Chinamen seated in the house and looking at the scene. One of them asks for music and the servant starts to play the instrument. On listening the mournful song, their faces that are full of wrinkles and their eyes starts shining brightly. The poet says that these Chinamen are not trying to escape from the truth of life, but they are participating and evaluating as well as accepting the tragic joy. Their gaiety is arising in the midst of the knowledge of sorrow. Thus, we must learn to rejoice and accept our immortality. And the fine arts helps us to understand and to accept the inevitable transience. Thank you. Have a nice day.